scientist, I am so glad you're here. Check out this flyer. It says there's going to be an epic meteor shower tonight. If we leave now, we can get to the park in 5 minutes, so we are ready for it. Let's go. I don't want to miss it. Are you coming? Didn't you hear me? There is going to be a huge meteor shower tonight. We have to hurry. What's that? It's not night yet? I guess you're right. It is day right now, but how are day and night different? To figure out the difference between day and night, we're going to need our guided notes ready. We are going to be recording our observations in a Venn diagram that looks like this. We use a Venn diagram when we want to compare and contrast two things, which means to describe what is similar and different about them. We know it is day right now, specifically the morning, so we are going to be writing our notes on the day side. Let's look around and see what we can observe about daytime. The first thing I observe is that the world around me is visible. I can see the sun in the sky, a few clouds, and blue sky too. Do you see anything else? When the sun is in the sky, the world around us is clearly visible without the use of artificial light, like lamps or flashlights. I can also feel the sun on my skin. The sun's heat warms up the world around us. Shh! Do you hear that? I can hear some birds chirping and some bees buzzing around too. There are a lot of animals that are awake and active during the daytime, just like humans. Let's write down all of our observations. Sunlight, blue sky, warmth from the sun, active animals. Pause the video here and take a moment to write down all of our observations in your Venn diagram. Feel free to add any extra observations you've made about daytime. Daytime is great, but when is it going to be nighttime so I can go see the meteor shower? Guess I'll just have to wait. Okay, I've been waiting for a while now, but everything looks about the same. The sun is still in the sky, the bees are still buzzing, and the sky is blue. Based on those observations, I can conclude it's still daytime and not yet time for the meteor shower. It seems like it's the afternoon. The only difference that I can see is that there are a few more clouds in the sky now. Even though we can't see the sun in the sky, we still know it is daytime because there is enough light from the sun to see the world around us. Well, I guess I'll keep waiting here until something changes. Now I have been waiting for what feels like forever, and we are starting to get somewhere. I can't see the sun anymore, and the sky is much darker. I don't hear any more birds or bees, but oh my goodness! I can hear and see bats flying in the air! Look at that! That must mean the birds and bees are beginning to rest for the night, and new animals are waking up. There are definitely some changes happening. And look over there! I can see the moon, too. This must be the nighttime you guys have been talking about! No? Are you sure? If it isn't nighttime yet, then it must be dusk. Dusk is when the sun has set, which means we can't see it in the sky anymore, but it is still partially lighting up our sky. The sky is going to have to be much darker for the meteor shower, so I guess I have to keep waiting. There sure are a lot of differences between night and day. I really hope this is worth the wait! Wow! You weren't kidding! Night is definitely worth the wait. Look at how dark the sky is. It is so much harder to see the world around me without the sun in the sky. But I can see other things so much more clearly. Look how magical all these stars are. They are shining so bright, and the moon is so much brighter than it was at dusk. That reminds me, did you know you can also see the moon during the day? It isn't nearly as bright, but it can often be found in the blue sky on a sunny day. Pause the video to jot down that observation. This note about the moon will go in the middle of the Venn diagram because it can be seen during both day and night. Wait, shh. Do you hear that? An owl. And lots of crickets, too. There are certain animals called nocturnal animals that are awake during the night and asleep during the day. They even have night vision to help them see in the dark. Owls, bats, and raccoons are all nocturnal animals. I'm also observing that the air is much cooler without the sun in the sky. The temperature has definitely dropped down a few degrees since the sun has gone down. Let's write down our observations. Remember to write these notes on the night side. Brighter moon. Nocturnal animals. Lots of stars. Very dark sky. Cooler temperatures. Pause the video here to write down all of these observations. Before we head to the meteor shower, let's double check that we understand the differences between day and night. It seems like the biggest difference between the two is the amount of sunlight. During the day, it is light, and during the night, it is dark. This changes what you can see in the sky, the color of the sky, and temperature of the air. During the day, the sun is up. On a sunny day like today, you will see the blue sky. It is also usually warmer during the day because of the heat from the sun. During the night, when meteor showers happen, the sky is very dark, almost black. You can see the moon and stars shining bright in the sky, and temperatures tend to be slightly cooler once the sun goes down. Now that we understand the differences between day and night, I am positive it is officially night. Let's hurry to the park. The meteor shower will start any minute now. Look at that. We made it just in time. Thank you for your help today and tonight, scientist. Remember, science is all around you. Hey, hey.